Welcome back to the channel. I'm going to show you guys how to sync up an 8-camera multicam shoot with mixed audio. And I'll link these files below so you guys can do the same. So I have a timeline down here with one video, one audio. And what we're going to do is grab all of our clips in the media bin and right click. We're going to create a new multicam clip using selected clips. I'm going to add sync. And we're going to leave it in 24. We're going to sync it with sound. And then for angle name, normally it's on sequential, but we're going to choose metadata camera. So it looks at the camera name, and then it's going to move these clips into an original bin. And we'll hit create. And now that bundled everything into the original bin, and now we have our multicam clip right here. And we could drag that into our source monitor here and slide to see where we're at as far as sync goes and make sure the on-screen action is matching, and it looks like it is. If you ever wanted to see the relationship of your sync, you can click on this multicam clip, right click, and say open in timeline, and that opens it up as its own timeline, which is essentially what a multicam clip is, except if we zoom in on the video here, it would normally be named angle, but now, because we told it to use the metadata, they're named appropriately with the camera names. And then if we zoom in and we go to the slate clap here, if we go to the audio, you can see everything's lined up, including our music track. We have a little bit of a countdown here on the camera audio, and then the music track starts. And then you could see if we solo that camera, the music, let's see if it matches up with our picture here. Okay. So don't leave that in solo, because anything you do inside of this multicam timeline will be reflective in your multicam clip up here. So I'll go ahead and take that out of solo. We can close this down. Now let's show you how to get your initial edit going. If we click on camera 5 here, you can see we don't have the multicam controls. We need to use our on-screen controls here and go down to multicam, and then we can hit play. You do have to go back to source if you want to slide around. So let's go here and drop the multicam back in here. We'll slide into just before the music starts. And now we'll go to multicam. So we need to make an initial edit here to get something down on our timeline to sync with the multicam. So let's go back to source, drag the multicam clip. We'll choose camera 5 and this music. We're just before the slate's about to start, and we'll do an append edit. And then go back here, you could see we've got the slate clap here, and we're now on camera music, but camera 5's the audio, and we're going to want the inverse. So we don't have any picture here because this camera music is black. So we actually wanted the opposite here. So let's redo that. We'll go ahead and delete this. Go back to the start here. Just drag that down. So now we have camera 5 picture and camera 5 audio. And now if we move over to our multicam, it'll sync up with whatever is on our timeline versus what's in the multicam clip preview. Everything's lined up, but we have the bad audio. So I'm going to go ahead and option click. And we're not going to delete this. We're actually going to right click and say switch multicam clip angle, and we'll choose the music bed for that file. Then we can lock it. And then to prevent overwriting, if we didn't lock it, this little section right here below your multicam clip, you can choose whether it's just video, audio, or audio alone. Right now we're on video, which is how we want it. Let's check the sync and make sure the audio did line up. You don't want to have to drag and drop it. You could just switch the angle like I showed you, and it should be right in sync here. Let's check. There we go. Okay, so now to edit your multicam clip, you can use the number keys above your letters on your keyboard. The number pad on mine isn't working. I don't know if that's just because I changed preferences, but I can switch to the camera angles if I hit the number, or I have a speed editor and I use that. For now, I'll just click with a mouse though. So if we were about to start here and we wanted to cut to the drummer, right now we're on angle 5. We can back up a little bit and just click in real time. So let's switch. There you go. That's how you can switch live on the fly and get a rough cut. Now, normally I'll hit W and switch over, or T to switch to my edit trim mode, but you can leave it on your arrow in multicam. And where you see these edit marks, hover over it and you get this bracket. You can slip your edit and the timing, the audio stays in the correct spot. So if this wasn't hitting quite where we wanted it when it cuts to the drummer, say we wanted it here, we could just slide that over. And once you've chosen that edit point, you can use your comma and period keys to move it frame by frame, and then hit your bracket, your forward slash to review your edit. Let's say we were lingering a little too long, you can just slide that over. And then conversely, if you didn't like the angle, like right now we're on angle 5, let's say we wanted to switch to 6. Right now there's a razor blade when we hover over the camera clips. You can hit option and then hover over and it turns to this swap. So right now we're on camera 5. We want to swap it to 6. Just click it and it keeps the timing and the cuts and the relationship. And now we're choosing camera 6 at this cut. And then if we want to edit, just click on over. And that's how you can edit your multicam clip, sync it all up with your external audio. And like I said, I'll link to these clips below. They're from Blackmagic Design. And you guys can experiment with syncing up your 8 camera multicam shoot and your mixed audio. All right, thanks for watching as always. And I'll talk to you guys on the next video.